Good morning, Mayra.
Good morning.
I will be your guide for today. My name is Vasiliki. And on behalf of the Grotta Hotel, I'd like to welcome you all in our beautiful island of Naxos.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's very kind of you.
I'm so happy to see you. I'm so happy to be in such a lovely spot from where you can see two of the major places that someone can visit and welcome the guests to Naxos when they arrive upon their arrival. So you can already see the beautiful Palatia Island over there, the islet, where the Temple of Apollo is located, with a beautiful view on the other side of the island of Delos, the holy island, the sacred island of Apollo. That's why it is located there, next to Mykonos Island, so we are very close. On the other side you can see Paros, and you can imagine that this narrow passage between Naxos and Paros was the most important part of the Aegean till the medieval times, we can say, till modern times. So who was controlling this passage could control the whole area of the Aegean. That's why it was such an important place for the Venetians. So when they arrived in the Aegean Sea, their purpose was to conquer Naxos Island. So when they conquered the island, and I will tell you the story later of how they did that, they have created the capital of the whole Duchy of Naxos and of the archipelago, as it is called, over there. So this is the town, the medieval town of Naxos, our castle with the cathedral on the top that dates back 1207, the cathedral and the castle. And you can imagine that from up there you have a view that covers all these passages, Paros, and of course all the other beaches of Naxos from where people could be easily attacked. So we will talk about ancient history, medieval history, and of course we will talk about today.
Wonderful.
Our modern times, Naxos is a very authentic island. So, talking about authenticity, I'm happy you enjoy beautiful Greek breakfast with melekouni, that is beautiful sesame with honey and different kind of herbs. This is a pie that we make with 7 ingredients. It is a vegan pie and we make it as a religious pie in special occasions. And the most famous sweets of Greece generally are what we call as the spoon sweets. They are fruits that we cook and then we serve them with a spoon. So that's why they have the name as spoon sweets. But what I see that is missing from here is cheese.
Oh yes.
And Naxos is very famous for the cheese. So let's go and see how we make it.
We are looking forward to it.
We're looking forward. Thank you so much. Let's go for a cheese.
So we are now in the area of Grotta, here.
By the beach, by the sea, I mean.
Yes, by the sea. We are actually in one of the oldest neighborhoods of Naxos, by the sea. And we are going to leave from Grotta in order to drive through the central part of the island. This is the biggest olive grove in the Cyclades and one of the oldest, with more than 100,000 olive trees. And we are going to lead ourselves to Agiassos, one of the remote, I can say, areas of Naxos, one of the virgin beaches of the area. And close to Agiassos is where our, ship owner is waiting for us in order to show how cheese is made.
Let's go.
Let's go. Thank you.
Καλημέρα!
Καλημέρα! Καλή χρονιά!
Επίσης, καλημέρα! Καλώς ήρθατε!
Καλώς σας βρήκαμε!
Επίσης, Μαρία, ενδείξεις Γιάννης!
Καλή Μαρία,
Γιάννης!
Γεια σας! Nice meeting you!
So today we are going to learn how to make two of the most typical Greek cheeses. Have on your mind that in Greece we have a variety of more than 120 cheeses with a certified name of an origin. Greece is the second country in Europe after France that has such a big variety of cheeses with a certified name of an origin. And here in Naxos we have Arsenico, that is the king of all the cheeses. It is a very hard cheese with a very strong taste, and that's why we call it Arsenico, that means the male. And when we make Arsenico, at the same time we make a soft white cheese that is called Misithra or Philico, that means the female. So with the same procedure, we make both Arsenico and Misithra. Mr. Yannis here has already started the procedure for us. He had milked his sheep and his goats, because this is 50% sheep's milk and 50% goat's milk. And he doesn't need that to be boiled. This is very important, have on your mind that the animals of Naxos are in a particular race and they go through special examinations, so the cheese has to be not pasteurized. Okay, Arsenico is a raw cheese. It is already 35 degrees Celsius, and now he will let it for an hour. So after an hour he will start making the procedure for giving to this milk its form. So Yannis now is curdling the cheese. It is already on fire. For me, it has become a soft cheese, almost something like between soft cheese and yogurt. And he uses that special stick that is made with the branch of an olive tree. Yannis has already put us in the procedure of making the Arsenico cheese. That's the male one that our friends are making right now in these baskets. In the old times they used to be made of bamboos,
Now we have those that we can use more than one time. And this is the procedure for making the strong cheese that is called arsenico. As I told you earlier, arsenico means the main. So they have to work fast. And each basket makes one cheese.
Need the next.
Αυτό
είναι ταξί. Θέλει να γεμίσει όλο το καλαθάκι. So we need to fill every basket and push it so the liquids do not stain. Κύριε Γιάννη, αυτό πόσο ώρα τα αφήνουμε μετά.
Κύριε Γιάννη, εντάξει, πώς το βλέπεις. Έχει όμως νερό.
Δεν είναι νερό, πρόβαλε.
Συγγνώμη.
Για να βάλουμε τα αλάτι μετά.
Τώρα να βάλουμε αλάτι.
Όχι, αυτό λέω, πόσο τα αφήνουμε για να πω τίποτα.
Την ώρα που θα τελειώσουμε την πλυζή θα βάλουμε τα αλάτι.
So we are making both the female and the male cheese.
We're making a few gregory.
We have two Nikes working here, so we are expecting the victory. Both cheeses.
Thank you so much for having this experience.
We really enjoy it.
What do you think? I think we are doing very well. We are so lucky that we are with Mr. Yannis.
How to
give the yes. Call?
Αδειάσαμε, του βάζουμε την άλλη. Εντάξει.
Αυτό δεν μπορώ να το κάνω εγώ.
Μπορείς.
Όχι, όχι, θα το χάσω.
Δεν το κάνω τουρίστε, δεν μπορείς να το κάνεις εσύ.
Πάμε, να το δοκιμάσουμε. Και να κάνουμε
γίνεται
για λάθο. Λοιπόν, θα σου
λίγο για να γυρνάω τώρα το πα.
Γυρνά έτσι, έτσι. Ρίξτε το γύρω, 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 γύρω για να ξεκολλήσεις.
Ρίξτε
το. Εντάξει, δώσ' του, γύρισε. Εντάξει, μπράβο. Γύρισε τώρα την άλλη μεριά του κουρί, αυτό εδώ. Έτσι, να δει την άλλη. Βάλε το χέρι σου, για να θα γεμίσει τα γύρω που αλλιώς θα λιώσει. Θα γεμίσει τα γάντια και ρόγα. Πες μου,
παιδιά. Here it is.
Wow, well done.
Amazing. It's very nice.
It's very nice. So do the next one as well. Do the next one. Go, go, go. Do it.
Okay. Ανοίξα το πιάσεις κανονικά, ε.
Ωραία. Ορίστε.
Αλλιώς, αλλιώς, αλλιώς. Έτσι, βέβαια. Αυτός.
Well done, Nikki. You're amazing doing that.
Εντάξει, είναι Νίκη, εντάξει. Θα κάτσε, θα κάτσε.
Oh, wow.
Θα κάτσε, okay. Και κάνε το έτσι, έτσι, χτύπα το. Έτσι, μπράβο.
Προχώρησε
τώρα. Wow, so έλα,
nice. Έλα, γιατί, βάζει.
It's a wonderful experience,
do it. Τώρα, τώρα. Τώρα, τώρα.
Χαμηλά, μην τα πετάξεις να έρθουν πάνω σου.
Wow, τώρα.
Απ' την άλλη μεριά θα το βάλεις τώρα.
Ναι, πού το.
Βάλε το χέρι σου, χωρίς το.
Wow, look at this. Amazing!
Δώσε μου το μήνα τώρα γιατί θα το βγάλεις.
Wow! Δεν τα βάλα καλά.
Εντάξει, εντάξει, μη φοβάσαι.
Σίγουρα.
Ναι. Εντάξει, το έχω σφίξει εγώ. Το πάρω πολύ
φορά. Sorry. Ωραία.
Βρες τώρα, το καραμπινάλι.
Το έχω βρει.
Βάλει την πυρογόνη μέσα. Γύρνα το. Γύρνα το. Μέσα, μέσα, μέσα.
Ah, it's there. Ah, so it's easier. It's easier when it's inside. Wow.
Γαμπάτι.
Wow, look at this.
Για στα χέρια σου.
Amazing. Wow. A very nice experience. Thank you so much for letting us do this.
You can see that these are the stamps, the official stamps that you can try and find out when you want to buy something like that. The cheese will have to remain like that for an hour. Then we will add the salt that you see here. And then we will let them dry for about 6 days, and they will need to stay in a dry place for minimum 3 months in order to be ready to be sold. So this is the male cheese from raw goats and sheep's milk. The soft cheese from the same milk after making the hard one that is called arsenico. Now we are making the female that is called Mizithra.
It's my favorite.
Yeah.
It has to be.
With honey on top.
Have on your mind that in different areas in Greece it might have a different name. This is the original way, so it is called sweet Mizithra. When you add salt, you make it salty, so it becomes Xeno Mizithra. Miss Maria here is the wife of Mr. Yannis. So Mr. Yannis showed us the male one, and Miss Maria now is going to show us how to make the female.
Εκεί θα με σώσεις.
Ναι.
Μετά από εδώ θα με σώσεις, εντάξει.
Εντάξει.
It's nice that it is a teamwork. It's like a family's job, as it used to be. Cheese is one of the most ancient products of Greece. In the old days, people knew how to make them and keep them in the caves. In Naxos, we have many caves that were used since at least the Neolithic era. And the geology of Naxos is playing a very important role in our traditions, because our products are connected to our earth.
Thank you, Nicoleta. It's really funny to help make your favorite cheese, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a very nice experience. Maria has told me that with honey on top it's the best. And now that it's warm,
we have to try it.
You have to try, yes.
And it smells wonderful.
Yeah, it's pity that we cannot smell.
Vasiliki, why the cheese of Naxos is really the best one?
I think because the island has such a big variety of herbs,
that our animals produce a milk that has a different taste. They are free range, they have the ability to go on the mountains and get a very big variety of food. Sometimes they cannot even go and drink water from the sea, so everything becomes naturally salty. So the products that come from these animals are different because our earth is different. Misitra is the most common cheese on our Greek salad. Feta is a cheese that we don't produce in Naxos. We might be producing that, but unofficially, because it has a certified name and origin from other areas. So you can imagine that the Greek salad, as it is called, is considered to be a complete meal with protein, with everything that the body needs. And it is a salad that has a variety of cheeses depending on the area where the Greek salad is produced, is made. So here in Athens, our Greek salad is the Naxian salad and is always served with Misitra cheese.
Misitra is also very good for a diet.
Yes.
It's not so fat.
It's not as fat as the arsenico, that's true. And it is a fresh cheese, so it's not very easy to find it in a supermarket. You have to go to the producers, because it is a cheese that cannot be kept for a long time. So in Naxos you can always have it fresh and locally made.
That's also a reason to be so tasty.
Wow.
This is part of our lunch.
Wow. Delicious. Wow, wow. Yummy, yummy. Yummy, yummy.